I feel like if we have like a credit score competition, I think we're doing swimmingly. But
I absolutely am.
Armenian's about 900.
Yeah,
I don't. I have no idea what my. I haven't borrowed money in over 7 years. Like I might literally be like someone before.
That is a problem. Your credit
is not a problem. My dad made that mistake, and he was like, "Oh, I don't have any credit anymore." I was like, "Wait, what do you mean you don't have any credit anymore? You've borrowed and paid back millions of dollars." He's like, "Not in the last 7 years. I have everything's paid off." And I'm just like, "We got to get you some credit cards. This is nonsense. There's no.
I just debit card mostly. I borrowed money from my truck. There was a rebate.
What's the point? I just don't understand. Yeah.
Everything is upcharged.
Use the Amazon card though, right? You've got that Synchrony Bank Amazon card where you get the 5% off.
Yeah. On Amazon Prime.
There you go. That's keeping things alive.
Killer.
Oh, yeah, but still, I mean, I feel like it's one of those things you should just always.
It's not a pure math equation with me, the finance. Like, I like not owing anyone anything.
Me too. That's why you pay it off after you make the purchase 2 days
later.
Just have
auto pay on. And
yeah, we do that on the Amazon as I think about it. The Amazon card.
Yeah. I use the
Amazon card. A real 600 score personally.
Like I don't use credit. Like my credit all my credit cards are literally sitting here in like a pile. Like I'm try very hard not to show any of my goddamn credit cards. But like I leave them here because they have like different ones have different rewards. And I use them for like online shopping and stuff like that. I don't care. I carry one credit card with me, the one that's got like the biggest like borrowing power on it for like emergencies. Like if I needed to like, I don't even know what I would need it for. I guess if I needed to like buy a car in an emergency or something ridiculous. I don't know. But
I carry a paper check in my first aid kit. Solved more problems than the gauze has. Like every so often, like I guess it's not medical. I haven't solved any medical problems with it, but I'm like, every time I go on a long trip, it's like, I should bring two or three checks. Sometimes shit gets done with a check.
That actually is a really reasonable thing to suggestion that I haven't thought about. You know, sometimes you just get in a little fender bender and you're like, fuck it. Here's $250. Go away.
It could be a fender bender. Yeah. In the last trip I went on, the trip before the last anyway, I bought a new motorcycle and there was like a weird thing. I traded in my old bike, but I didn't have the title on me. So whatever, I was able to give them a check that they just never cashed and it solved problems. One time I was buying a new lawnmower. It turns out my debit card didn't have, it was expensive. It was like 15 grand or something. Mm. Couldn't put that on the debit card. So I run to the first aid kit, get a check. You know, solve problems.
I love it. That's a very practical thing that I think I've been around the block enough to know that a blank check in my glove box is a good one, or not even glove box, medical kit. You know, like nobody's gonna rob you at gunpoint and be like, check the medical kit.
Yeah, you don't know when a check is gonna get you out of a jam.
Yeah, that's a good one for sure. I've got pictures in my phone of like stuff like that, so I've got like. I can run the numbers, like the routing numbers and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Like a bunch of stuff like that's good to like have in your phone in a locked folder. And, you know, like so you can just like have access to as much money as you need, I guess.
Can you lock pictures? It sounded like you locked.
Yeah. You didn't have
password. Yeah.
Well, I mean, beyond that, you can have like locked folders as well, like with locks within locks.
I wonder if iPhone does that.
I'm sure.
There's apps for
I'm
it.
Sure. If my $100 Pixel does it, and then your iPhone does it.
Pixel, Google has it built in native, but Apple, you need a third party. It's not the end of the world. It's just an extra step.
Yeah, it's not a big deal. But and then with like the credit card thing, like I got, I think the most recent one I got was that Delta card.
Good rewards on that one.
Yeah, the rewards are so sick. My flight was basically for free. Once I like put it on the card, like
it's like $500 free for like for signing up to Delta's $500 in flight credit for signing up to Delta's like credit card immediately. And then
I got so many miles, like I've already got like 200,000 or 300,000 Delta miles.
Hmm.
So I was just like, oh, this Colorado trip was going to be free. I'm definitely going first class so I can bring my bags because I'm bringing so much gear with me anyway for like filming. And but then it was just like, no, only use half of it. Only pay for half of it with miles and pay for the other half with the card. And not only do you make more miles, but like, I don't remember how much cash back they gave me for like booking a flight. But it, like you said, it was like $300 to $500 of
like per year
free money.
No, of like that initial purchase. Yeah. Because like, if you sign on, you know, people, myself included, kind of scoff at the idea of when they do like, hey, we're going to land soon. If you guys want to apply for a credit card, we're going to give you 50,000 bonus miles. whatever.
Not bad.
Like, it, I mean, it's not bad, but sometimes on these international flights, it's basically like a free $250. You can just use a credit card for like a month or two, put $40 on it, and then you're good to go. Close that one out. You got the miles. You're good to go.
Right. Yep.
So
I
credit cards.
Do that.
It's called churning. Yeah. There's like a big community online about it. I work them pretty well as well. I've been using the same Chase card since like I started doing YouTube, and
I
cannot bring myself to spend the points. I'm just like, I want to keep getting that high score and going and going. And Chase, like, if you have their Sapphire Reserve card, you get 1.5x on your redemptions. So I think I have like $23,000 in travel or something like that. And I'm just like, eventually one day I'm not going to have any sponsorships or like YouTube travel, and I'm just going to be able to travel the world for free. So that's my goal.
That's kind of what I've done with my miles over the years. It was like, why would I use my miles? I just use money. I have money. Right. Like just let the miles keep accruing. They don't expire. And at this point I could fly around the world if I could find enough countries that would allow my felonious ass to land. I could fly back and forth to Colorado at first class, like a dozen fucking times or something. Like,